What's good, everybody? You know who it is. You know the city gods in the building. Ain't shit, as usual. Today, I'm going to go over how I made this dancehall beat called Contagious. If y'all want this beat, y'all can just send me an email or send me a text on my phone or WhatsApp. However you can send me a text. And I'll let y'all use this beat for free. It's free for non-profitable use. Only though, if you want to use it, you know, and you want your commercial rights for this shit, you know, you just hit me up. We talk, you know what I'm saying? Negotiations, and I'll let y'all use that beat. But if y'all want it exclusive, we can talk about that too, where you'll be the only one using that beat. Alright, one of these days I may go over the different types of leasing contracts that y'all artists that need to know about, including producers also coming up in JA. Alright, I'm gonna get down to this beat breakdown but first I'm gonna let y'all hear what I got so far. So I'm gonna play it and let y'all hear what I got so far. And also, y'all can just hit that like button, subscribe, you know, share this video with your friends, you know what I'm saying? Y'all can learn a lot from my tutorials and, you know, and how to have a good sound selection and stuff like that. All right, here it goes. Purchase your track today. So far, now I'm gonna get down to the breakdown section. Now I'm gonna get down to that part. Okay, I use this pluck. Where is this nigga? All right, here it is. All right, I use Serum for this beat. The preset that I use, it's a stock preset though. The plugin is. I'm talking about plugin. The plug preset is Phantom. I use Phantom SD. Trust me, it's a really good sound to use. You know what I'm saying? It's a really good sound to use. And if you watch my earlier tutorial where I talk about the melodic scales, you know, that you would use to get these, you know, to form your chord progression, your notes and stuff like that, you can simply just hit the stamp icon and just choose on the melodic scale. Mostly I use the major, sometimes I use harmonic minor for the dark, you know, the dark vibe. Major can be used for that too. And even the minor natural Aeolian scale. But you don't have to do that. You can just hit this little piano roll option icon up here and go to helpers, scale highlighting, and you choose the scale that you want. If you choose major scale, you're gonna go back again, and then you choose the root note that you want your beat, the scale to be in. So for example, if I choose F sharp, you're gonna see the root note show up here. So we're in the scale of F sharp, right? But I'm just gonna go back to my default. All right, here's what the plug sounds like. That's just a pluck. I have this synth one shot. I downloaded this synth. I got this off a one shot kit. Where is that one shot kit? Yeah, I think I got it out of this one shot kit right here. Yeah, this one shot kit. It's called Crystal CT. Oh, probably that's a producer's name. Love one shot. Kid, but producer's name is probably Crystal CT. I got it off that one shot kit. It's really dope. I got it off that dope kit. It's real dope. Ain't no lie about that. Now this is my snare roll. I've been getting, you know, text on IG and stuff about how I created my snare rolls. But what you do is, once you have a note like this, you know what I'm saying? You can just have it like that, you know what I'm saying? Right? Or what you could actually do, you could just have your notes up here be in, you know, just hit the snap to grid, and you just change how your grid appears, and you know, you can keep it in 1/3 beat, and that's how you can create the snare like that. You just, you know what I'm saying? That chop snare. Like that. Alright, now the bass. Now this bass, I know a lot of people never really heard bass like this in dancehall beats, but it's good to be creative. It's good to, you know, have your own swing to it. I use this bass called Thick One from Massive, the old version Massive. I got the new one, Massive X, but you know, not many presets around for that one. Now this is what a bass sounds like. Sounds really good with the 808 along with the pattern. Trust me, like this shit, like hot. I'ma let y'all hear it with. Hold on, I forgot I had this thing on. That's how it sounds. It also sounds good with the 808 with it too. This comes in right after, you know, right after. Yo, that shit, dope. Like, you could just, you know, add a little creative to your dancehall beats. Be creative about it. This is just a kick pattern, though. You know, basic kick pattern. That Summer Walker kick. People be asking, though, like, where I got my drum kits, you know. I just downloaded them Trap drum kits, because that's where you tend to find, like, the hard kicks, you know, nice snares. I mostly downloaded drum kits, like, the R&B-style drum kits, or I use the trap drum kits, them little baby type drum kits, Summer Walker type drum kits, you know. Drum kits like those. Trust me, like, I even use packs from TB Digital, you know, Producer Grind. I even use packs from these guys. I also have that Zone 6 for Neutral drum kit. Like, yo, you got some nice sounds in that. So, I mean, y'all can just go cop those kits, you know what I'm saying? Like, that shit really dope. I need to grab more kits, but you know how it is. And shit. This is the kick pattern right here. If your kick already has that hard hitting sound, you don't have to add anything to it more than just a level in that sound. And you, to sidechain that with the 808, you use that Fruity Peak controller and sidechain it with your 808. To do that, you click on the leveler, this leveler right here, the volume knob, and copy the value, and you go over to the peak controller. You just hit the bass right here, and you're gonna paste. You're gonna hit this, and then you're gonna click on paste. Once you copy, you're gonna see paste come up, and you paste the value here. Once you do that, you adjust the volume knob right here, right, and the tension and the decay, which, you know, once the bass start hitting with the kick, you're gonna see these little dips right here, and that's how the value for it is, how, like, if once it had that loud dip, you'll hear it. So you adjust the volume so you don't really hear that, you know, big dip in the whole entire beat. This tension and decay, you use to adjust that and the timing, stuff like that. I'm going over to the 808. Alright, it's the 808 right here. If you notice, it's kind of similar to the other bass pattern. And the bass is different from the 808, though. Don't get that wrong. A lot of people tend to get that wrong. The bass in the 808 is different. Now you have it like that, you know? get that dip I have right here, I just hit the slide icon. It just, you know, drop my note here and just my note to a level and just get that, you know what I'm saying? You get that dip, you know what I'm saying? You also can use the same slide technique to give that 808 that reverse, not really say reverse type of feel or vibe, but you get that push and pull type of vibe. I think I did that one time in a trap beat that I made, a 2C vibe trap beat. This is my snare. Just that basic pan right there. I have another snare, you know, the counter snare. That's that counter snare. You just had that, you know what I'm saying? Give that bounce to it. You can add the trap style to it, give it a bounce. This is the same pattern that I have for the pluck. This is a synth that I use out of GMS, Epic Chords TE. Like, this is a good plugin, as I said before in one of my tutorials. It's a good plugin to use when you make your dancehall beats. The stock sounds are really good, but you can download presets for these plugins. You know, you can get them off YouTube, Google, because you have other producers, you know, make their own custom kits for it, or they advertise other kits that they downloaded and stuff like that. Yeah, you want to have something like this to blend with your pluck so you don't have that whole beat sounding dry, and, you know, you won't add too much reverb to it. I'm saying this is just a stock plugin, it's just a stock reverb, but I have the Valhalla Plate, Valhalla Ruin, the Valhalla Vintage Verb. You can download those. I even got, you know, Echo Boys plugin where, you know, Sound Toys plugin, sorry, not Echo Boys, but Sound Toys plugin. And you can go to Spaces, you know, there's many reverb type of feel right here. Ambient Space, I use Ambient Space a lot on a lot of sounds. You know what I'm saying? Echo Boy here, you know, and that reverb vibe to it too. You know what I'm saying? You got a reverb in Spaces, you can just use that here. You can even add these effects on vocals also. Alright, this is a pluck art. I got this out of Harmless. Saying that's just the basic vibe for it. That's just the basic vibe for it. It's just my hi-hats right now. Also, what you can do with your hi-hats too, you can just like change the pitch, adjust the pitch down to like 300 cents, you know. And it gives it a different sound instead of just dropping it down in the octave or the semitones. You know what I'm saying? It sounds good like that. You know, I'm going to leave it right there. I'm going to lay that stereo right there. So when I play the beat out there, it sounds a little bit different. This is a lead that I use. I got this lead from Silent. It's an old school lead. I got this lead out of the Trapso bank that I have. Or a Silent plugin. It's a really good bank to have. Where did I get this again? Producer Plug. You can get that off producerplug.com. This sounds really good with the whole, you know what I'm saying, with the whole beat. I'm gonna let y'all hear that too. Where's that lead? The lead is, where did I put it? Oh, I think it's way down here. This is a lead right here. And just your tracks. Sounds good with it. And with the 808, whenever the kick and the 808 slide doesn't hit, you tend to hear the other bass comes in with that. I'm saying that gives like a bouncy vibe. You can just blend to you know, blend that 808 and a bass together. It's a good combo. combination. You just have to find the right, you just have to find the right sound to use. You know, this is a, right here. This is a basic open hat right here. Hold on. This is a basic open hat right here. Yeah. So once you have this good sound, you don't really have to like be sitting down practicing mixing and shit like that, mixing out stuff. Like, I learned a lot from watching, you know, TB Digital's video of Producer Grind. It's mostly trap tutorials and stuff like that, but you can learn a lot from watching trap tutorials and how to mix your beats, because I tend to mix my dancehall beats, like how they mix the trap beats, but it's kind of similar. I learned a lot, and about sound selection, you know, using the right sounds and stuff like that. You know, once you have your good sounds, you don't need to do all that mixing. Like, it's easier for you to just, you know, make that beat, get that sounding good, feeling good. Then the engineer will take over from there when it comes down to the whole vocals thing and the beat and stuff like that. So you don't have to too worry about that. This is just an open hat that I use from a pack called Antidote. It's like a Travis Scott drum kit, though. This is a really good hat. I just used it for like a percussion when it starts, you know, saying a dark feel. I could have added a bell, but the bell wouldn't sound real good. So I just, you know, I just used that with it, and that's just it, you know what I'm saying? And thanks again for tuning in into this tutorial. I know it's not really much, but don't worry about it. I'm gonna drop more tutorials that y'all can really sit down and really watch, where, you know, I make these beats from scratch. And, you know, sometimes creating these beats take time. They, you know, and I'm a beginner myself. I'm not gonna be like I'm a pro. I'm not really pro with all of this yet. I'm still a beginner myself, but I've been doing this for a while now. There's a lot to learn. I'm just in between dancehall and trap beats because I love hip hop. So most times I'll be on that hip hop shit, but my YouTube community be, you know, be based off dancehall right now. People tuning in, so I just be on this for right now. So I'm gonna drop more tutorials. I'm gonna drop beats, you know what I'm saying? Let y'all whip in, grab what y'all need to grab. I'm down. So thanks again for y'all tuning in. You know, see the guys, you know what I'm saying? Ain't shit. You know how we do, you know how we do. Alright, I'm gonna get this video started out and upload. So let's get it. Thank y'all again for watching, man.